Hi, hello, namaste, welcome to Amrita Academy. So today I'm back in the video. So this video is going to be unique and special. Okay, so first, do you people know most of our body parts need metals? So, and a quick disclaimer before I start this topic, that which part of the body need which metal. So metals need to be taken appropriately. So everything need to be taken in appropriate quantities and in a balanced diet. So if you take it more, it would be a bigger problem. If you take it less, it would also be a problem. So always take these metals for your body parts in appropriate quantities and in a balanced diet. So let's start. So the first body part, teeth and the bones. So the teeth and the bones need the metals like magnesium and calcium. So you can intake magnesium through foods like dark chocolate and avocado. And for calcium, everybody know, like the parents are forcing us like drink milk, drink milk, drink milk. So of course milk and cheese and the other dairy products. So the next body part is liver. So manganese, Mn, this metal is needed in the liver. So this manganese helps the metabolism of cholesterol and carbohydrates in the liver, and it helps the proteins and amino acids digestion in the liver. So to intake manganese through your food, you can intake food like legumes, whole grains, clams, nuts, tea, coffee, and it's also present in water. So the next body part is kidney. So the metal needed, the metals needed for kidney are little percent of sodium, potassium, and phosphorus. So the food you can include to your diet for these metals are, for potassium and phosphorus, you can include like nuts, seeds, whole wheat cereals. And for little percent of sodium, you can include like lentils and beans. So the next body part are eyes. So for eyes, the essential elements are zinc, calcium, magnesium, and iron. So these are the essential trace elements for the development of eyes. But silver, lead, gold, mercury, these are the metals which are automatically absorbed through optic membranes. So for the metals like zinc, calcium, magnesium, and iron, you can intake food like nuts, seeds, and cocoa, eggs, and dairy products. And the next is hemoglobin. So this is the O2 carrying chemical in the red blood cells, RBC. So blood is present all over our body. So iron is needed for our hemoglobin, which is blood. So you can intake iron through leafy vegetables, leafy greens, and potatoes and tomatoes. So another body part is heart. So without this, we cannot live. So for this part, we need copper, Cu. So this incorporates into a variety of protein and metalloenzymes, which perform the essential metabolic functions. So to have copper into your diet, you can intake food like oysters, other shellfish, and like greeny vegetables, whole grains, and yeast. Last but not the least, another main organ, which is brain. So without brain, we cannot work, we cannot learn, we cannot actually do things. So yeah, so for brain, an essential metal is copper. It is crucial for the normal development of brain and the nervous system. So it plays a crucial role. It plays a central role for the conversion of iron, which is ferrous, to its useful form, ferric form, and also it helps transport iron in human body. So to intake copper, we need food in our diet like dry leaf, dry fruits, and dark leafy greens and potatoes. So this is all for this episode. So for all these main body parts to function, need all these metals. Many of these people don't know, and they don't include these food items to their diet. And that's why they're lacking or they're getting diseases. So always from now, include these all to your diet to have a balanced diet and to not get diseases or anything in your future, so that you'll be healthy. So stay healthy, be healthy, and spread positivity. So hope this was informative and you all liked it. So don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell icon for every new update of every new video. This is Amrita signing off. Bye.